By the end of the first meditation, Descartes was in a state of universal doubt. By understanding that the senses do deceive us, and we have found ourselves in dreams indistinguishable from reality, it is possible that they always deceive us, and we are permanently in a dream state. Descartes envisioned an evil demon which is set upon deceiving us in every possible way. Descartes concludes by doubting the existence of the physical world, and with that, doubting the existence of his body, his senses, and everything around him.
Yes, this was a very interesting conclusion he reasoned to.
Indeed. In the second meditation, he continues this line of thought and carries on doubting. But now he asks, if he is doubting the existence of everything, is he, as a living being, included in this everything? Is it possible that his existence is in fact a deception? If he now understands that he doubts the existence of the physical world and his own body, is he separate from his body, or is he one and the same? If he is one and the same, then he now finds himself in a situation where he is doubting his very existence. Can it be that the evil demon has created it so that we believe we are alive when in fact we are not? We do not live. We are in fact being deceived into thinking we are living beings.
Well, this is a very scary thought. So, does Descartes conclude that he does not actually exist?
Well, no. As Descartes carries on his meditation, he does not feel right in doubting his own existence. He asks, I myself, am I not at least something?
But if he has denied the existence of his body and senses, then why would his whole existence not go along with this?
Again, Descartes asks, am I so dependent on body and senses that I cannot exist without these? Although there may be an evil demon deceiving us at every point, Descartes realizes that he exists as long as he is something. And then Descartes has the epiphany. It is thought.
Thought, as in thinking.
Exactly that. Descartes realizes he is thinking. He has thoughts. He is a thinking being. And as long as Descartes is able to think, he knows he exists. And so the famous quote was coined. Cogito ergo sum. I think, therefore I am.
Interesting.
It really is. So Descartes has assured himself of the vital factor that he exists, but now he must go further. It is all well and good saying that I exist because...